Hey there, if you want to follow along exactly with this video, there are some exercise files that you can download. There is a link in the description, they're free to download. The other thing you might do is, this is a free video from my larger user experience design course. If you enjoy the video and like my teaching style, you might want to check out the full course. There'll be a link in the description as well. All right, on to the video. Hi there, welcome to the video all about type in XD. Actually, just getting the basics right. Now, if you are an Adobe nerd and you're like, man, what am I gonna learn from this type video? Stick around, XD has some quirky text things. Plus, we throw in some tricks and tips for distributing and duplicating. It's worth your time, hang about, let's get started. All right, to get started, grab the capital T tool and I'm going to zoom in a little bit. I'm gonna use my shortcut, Command 1. Okay, Commands 1's really good when you're dealing with type, so it's Control 1 on a PC. That gets you to 100%. Remember, it's just better to be dealing with that when you're dealing with text, okay? Be seeing it the actual size that your audience is gonna see it when you're making decisions on how big it is and how small it is. So, grab the capital T, and there's two type boxes. If you click once, you get what's called a point text box, okay? And this is good for headings, and it goes on and on forever, okay? That's just the way it is. The other type box, if I go back to my black arrow, okay, to kind of deselect out of that, and then go back to my type tool, and if I click hold and drag, I get what's called an area text box, okay? And the difference between this is when I mash it, see what happens? It's got a fixed width. So headings, body copy, navigation, body copy. You only use this for body copy. Things that have like multiple paragraphs and, I don't know, Lauren Ipsum, that type of stuff. You can convert each of them. I could say black arrow. I could say I want to be an area type box now. That there's the little icon for point text. That's the one for area text. So you click on this. Nothing, it kind of changes a little bit over here, but what happens? If I double click to get inside, I can start typing and you can see it has a fixed width. The weird thing about it though is the actual height of that box is just that blue dotted line. Look what happens when I go back to my black arrow, because there's all this other text. What happens to it? Just kind of disappears. I'm gonna move it down so you can see it. But it just gets kind of lost underneath this. So that's what this little blue dot in the middle of this white circle is meant to indicate. If I drag it down, any of these icons, if I drag it down, you can see there he is there. So if you end up with a box like this, and you make it too small, okay, that little blue dot appears and it's not as important. It's called overset text in something like InDesign. It's not super important when you're doing a mock-up. It might be though. So keep an eye out for the little blue dot. So you can convert one to the other. Point text, area text. All right, a couple of things. We're gonna go move in now and start kind of fixing up our navigation. Now, when you are working in wireframes, don't be picking fonts, okay? I'm just gonna leave it as Arial. You leave it as something really simple. It's not a time to be picking fonts. We'll do proper fonts a little bit later in the course when we start doing high fidelity. We'll look at a little bit more. The real basics though, before we move on, is I've got this box selected. You can see over here, I'm not gonna go through everything. I am actually, because it's real quick. Left align, center, right align. Okay, you've got underline. This is the space between letters. So if I put it up to 20, it's gonna open up the, let's put it up to something really high, 200. Okay, space between letters, that's the space between lines, put it up to 50. And this is the space after the paragraph. So if I go into here and I put a return in between these two and I open it up, so I put a return in there, there's no spacing, but if I go, actually I like spacing when there's a return, you can see not between the lines, but after there's a return. So that's where I put our little enter in. All right, a couple other things to show you about text, a little quickie in XD. I'm gonna delete that stuff. And what I want to do is, I don't wanna use this, this is an XD logo, I'm just gonna delete it. I'm gonna put in the company name. Don't be tempted to put in the logo here. Like, it's really hard as a designer to not start putting in the logo, but then you start using the brand colors and then the fonts, and then wireframe is not a wireframe anymore. It's like a half baked high-res version. So just stick to the actual text. So uppercase is kind of a nice way to remove any kind of design from it. Just keep it all very standard. The only thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna select all the text and make it white so it can be seen at least across this. The other thing is font size. Remember, I'm at 100%. Remember, Command 1 on a Mac, Control 1 on a PC. So I'm picking the right size, and it's quite big, right? So a real common body copy size, well, for wireframes, is 16 pixels. So I just clicked it over here and hit 16 and hit return. So often I'll just have 16 everywhere. Maybe the headings will be a slightly bigger size to indicate kind of what are headings and what are not. The other thing to do is on the black arrow, can you see this little white dot here? Okay, when you're in point text, okay, which pretty much, most of the text that I'm doing here, except for big chunks of body copy, are going to be this point text. You see this little dot here, and it does a couple of things. It's kind of weird. If you click hold and drag it down, it's a great way of adjusting the size. Okay, so this one here doesn't have a drop down or a slider, so you have to keep typing it in there. So if you just like a little bit bigger, a little bit smaller, just drag that. The other weird thing it does is, you can see there, if I'm right over the top of it, it's up and down. If I come out just a little bit, so not quite on the circle, but just outside anywhere here, click hold and drag it, it's rotating. Now you can see it over here, there's my rotation, and it's up to you, but I'd stay away from rotating text. It's quite hard to do in an app and coding a website, weirdly. It can be done, but yeah. Your developer might hate you if you start rotating text and he's got to go try and make a consistent rotated text. You'd have to have real good justification for that pain. But anyway, so we've got our text here. A couple of things. I want to, like this here, what is this? This is set to 10 point. Mine is a little bit small for what I need. So I'm going to click it, delete it. Goodbye, guys. I'm going to duplicate this across. You can copy and paste it. Okay. If you select something and go edit, copy, and then edit, paste, it just ends up over the top of it. So you can see they're just there. So what I find is a little easier is with the black arrow. So click, before you start dragging, so I'm gonna drag it over here, hold down the Option key on a Mac or Alt key on a PC. You can see just kind of while you're dragging makes a copy. I find that quite useful. So I want a couple of things. So this first one here on my wireframe is going to be the example. We're gonna like have an example version of it. I'm going to hold down my option and drag. I have a pricing. So you type this in as well. Now, the reason we are keeping these in separate boxes, because obviously I could just put in space, 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 and then put in login, and that's fine. Two things. One is it's hard to kind of adjust that spacing, but that's not a real big problem. What ends up happening is in XD, which we'll see later on when we start doing mockups, if this is one big text box with all the different like words in it, you can only get it to be a navigation item for one thing. Because it's one text box, you can say this whole block of text goes to the example page, but you can't split it up. So with these all in their own little type boxes, it means later on when we get in the course, we can actually get this button to go to something different from this one. So you'll get in the habit of that. So I'm gonna have a couple of these. I'm gonna have login, and we're gonna have start trial. Start trial. Okay, another thing while we're here is, you can see I can see the edge of this thing. If you can't see it, sometimes clicking the white background, or clicking the edge of the artboard is a nice easy, double click on the edge of the artboard is a nice easy way to select the whole artboard. Otherwise, it's clicking on the name. When you've got the whole artboard selected, you can adjust these columns here. Mine's quite light. I'm gonna adjust mine mainly because I want you to be able to see it. Okay, you can see it there through the video. Sometimes the videos don't show the contrast very well. Anyway, that's a handy trick. Double click the edge and you get the artboard kind of overall settings. That is not the trick I wanted to give you. The one is I want this to kind of line up close to here. I want them to be all kind of distributed, so on the same spacings. There's a couple of ways you can do it. You can select them all. Okay, so I've got everything selected, including my nav. I'm gonna hold shift and click the navigation. Okay, so that deselects it. That's maybe a bit advanced here. So let's just go click, hold shift, hold shift, hold shift, hold shift. So I'm holding shift when I'm clicking them, makes a nice big selection. And up here, there's your aligns. Okay, I want this one here, the distribute horizontally. You can see there's some shortcuts up there. Okay, I'm gonna click on it, and it just spreads them all out. What you will find though in XD is, let's say I don't do that. Let's say I line this one up. Okay, and I'm like, yeah, that's about perfect. If I start dragging this, I'm not doing anything. Can you see those little helpful smart guides appearing? And you can see when I get to here, it's kind of like the little pink thing appears and says, oh, would you like them to be 41 pixels apart? And you're like, yeah, man, that is too good. Look at that. Okay, I end up doing that a lot more than kind of trying to remember the shortcut, or I have problems with horizontal and vertical. I always click the wrong one. Anyway, all right, so that's the basics for text. We are going to look at it a lot better later on when we get into kind of web-based fonts and do some fancier things. But for the moment, that's what we need to get going with our wireframe. Simple text, point text, area text. There was a couple of other little tricks in there. All right, let's jump into the next video. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up, really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.